What's up, YouTubers? Excuse me. Today I'm going to show you how to speed up Windows XP. Now, if some of you don't have XP anymore, I am sorry, I can't upgrade because I don't have that kind of computer yet. Now, here we go, because I don't want to get this too far carried away. Now, if your computer is very low on memory, I recommend that you go to the classic style. I know it's ugly and everything, but believe me, you'll save 3 megs of memory if you apply this. Let me show you what it looks like real quick. Here we go, please wait, blah blah. And here it comes. See, I know it's not everything cool and everything, but you could actually save 3 megs by just applying this theme. And I'll apply it back when I'm done. You could right click under your hard drive, see how faster it's performing now. You could use disk cleanup. You could go into defragment, back it up onto another hard drive, not yours, because that would back up your entire hard drive, and you would probably waste your whole hard drive by just backing it up. Do that once a month, I would suppose. Check it for errors. Be sure that none of the hard drive sectors are going bad, because a hard drive is like a record, and it spins round and round, and everything that's active is a 1. And everything that's deactivated is a 0. Is a 0. I spoke too fast. My bad. Alright, and go into control panel and then find some programs and add or remove programs that you don't really use. Like, if you have a program from like 2008, delete it. Except if it's in use. Like, I have to get rid of some of my printer stuff here. Let's see here. Let's just say the drivers we need, because or else it won't work. I need Dragon, naturally speaking. This is for my iPod. Yeah, keep your computer as clean as possible. Let's see here if I can find something. No, I think I got rid of it already. But anyway, go in there, find programs that you don't. If you are running Windows XP Service Pack 3 and you're running professional, you'll get this free program later on, which is kind of fun. Then you don't have to install more software to help it. And go in here and look for unused programs and install them from there. Or you could go in the hard drive program files and delete them from here. Delete the access files that has left. Delete the, won't let me yet. Delete the sample backgrounds Windows gives you for XP. Delete the, service pack, no. Delete the readmes from Windows updates. Now it doesn't come with XP, no, Vista and 7. Doesn't have the shortcuts like that anymore, so you have to find them yourself. You could go into the DLL cache, which is highly recommended because you could save a couple of megs there. And delete some unused icons on your desktop, but be careful not to delete your folders. And that's how you pretty much speed up XP. And you could go into configuration. Now this is the performance side. Don't leave this be, leave that be, leave that be. Leave everything else be, and hide all the Microsoft services before you screw something up, and uncheck everything that you don't want. You could disable them all if you want, and then uncheck everything in the startup that you don't want. Kaufman, don't. Just leave that be, because it'll come back. And that's pretty much it, how to speed up XP, and thanks for watching. Oh, and by the way, if you want to free up memory, go in Task Messenger, sort it by name, and try to find something that's really taking up a lot of space. Usually, if you're running low memory, your Explorer would take the most. Right now, I am not taking that much memory, which is fantastic. Look at the performance. Right now, I'm using 50% to 40, which is pretty bad. It's an old computer, so no duh, right? And here's the memory page. You don't have to worry about that. If it turns red, then you're in trouble. That means you're too low. And I apologize if I'm talking too fast. You can always pause the video or rewind it. Networking, I don't know how to work that. Processes, worry, pretty much applications are what you're running, and then if you don't know what the exe file is, just right click and go to process, and it'll tell you exactly what it is, and you can delete it if you want. And that's pretty much it, really. How to speed up Windows XP. Alright, thanks for watching. Bye now.